Hello everyone, I'm Li Wenyi. Welcome to Taiwan is my home. A saying goes that at home one depends on their parents, abroad they help the friends. Our first character today might have a strong feeling to this saying. She married to a Taiwanese husband when she was 21, and she got a cute daughter, but however not so long, the couple split. She got 3 jobs a day to support the family. Then she decided to open a store selling vegetarian steaming buns. She made her hometown food sour soup and tofu, stuffing the buns to show her appreciation. On those who helped her out, the steaming bun is called Noble Buns. At 6 a.m. in the morning, Lu is rushing over to the store. After turning on all the lights, she walks around and her hands never stops. What do you want to eat for today? Setting first stove at 7 o'clock in the puffing white smoke heat, clipping the buns, serving today's first customer. 2 tofu buns and 3 gain buns, please. I always cooperate with you since you want to eat more sauce, please.
Sure.
And some tofu buns, pan fried stump buns are tasty too. I would get 2 first and 2 more this. Where are you heading for?
We're going to ride bicycles.
When she meets her hometown fellow customers, no matter how Lu busy is, she will use her hometown language to chat with them a bit. After taking care of the customers, Lu turns around to the kitchen to prepare ingredients. Her hard efforts could be tracked to the past. When she was 21, she visited her sister in Kunming from Guizhou and met her ex-husband from Taiwan, who visited her relatives. They had a flash marriage and had a daughter. In 1995, the whole family moved back to Taiwan and settled down. Unexpectedly, the couple split. Her husband had employed for a long time. Lu has turned the bargain alone for 20 years. Since I came to Taiwan, I made my own living. I depend on my own. In fact, it turned out like my situation now for all the time. I always work outside from morning to evening, hold a job and then go to take more available jobs as a shopkeeper at night. Reluctant to let her daughter suffer, once she left her 1.5-year-old daughter in Guizhou for 6 months because of the impact of separation with parents, development of her daughter's delayed once. In fact, for a child, it's quite because until she was 3 or 4 years old, she couldn't speak. Because I took her to move around and we were not able to settle down. We stayed here for a few months and there are some months, and then before she got used to the environment, she had to move to other places. She took her daughter back with her. Lu spent a whole year working for doctors to help her daughter, burning the candles for the both ends with work and family. She had to face her unemployed husband to take money from her and mess around. But 5 years ago, her daughter's words make her decision. My daughter told me that she said, "Mom, I think divorcing with father will be better for you and it's better for me too." For her daughter, she had to be tough. Lu, just a person with 3 jobs. In the morning, she works as a store selling pan-fried stump buns, and her job was took the stuffing in buns. In the afternoon, she went to ramen restaurant to clean dishes. In the evening, she's not end yet. She had a night shift in the electronic factory. Among these jobs, only pan-fried stump buns interest most. In my hometown, when I was little, I would love to do this kind of food. Before she applied the experience that she worked in the pan-fried stuffed buns and set up a small store. However, every day there was no customer until one day there was one customer. The customer gave her a suggestion to selling the handmade vegan buns, which no one else would buy. What is the stuffing for the vegan buns? Lu thought that her favorite Guizhou sour soup could be used for this filling. People for Guizhou, whatever he wants, he will definitely eat a power of sour soup. It is said that Guizhou will take a sour for 3 days, they have strength to walk. Just like losing the power of the whole body, will that happen to you too?
Yes!
Well, for example, when we go home, when we go to Kunming, my sister always cook a pot of sour soup for me. Also for Guizhou tofu bun, Lu keeps his taste, the chewy taste of dove wrapping and the texture of tofu. She tastes from the change for all, because tofu in Taiwan, in whose hands, is vegetarian. At that time, life condition was not that good. It's just kind of nice to really have tofu to eat.
Most of the dishes are made of tofu without meat. Yes, just a little meat. Because in China, we don't have Asian basil, the taste of tofu would be more intense. Because I make vegetarian buns, making these, I don't use garlic and green onions, so I make Asian basil. Because the buns I make are all vegetarian.You add it with green onions when you are in Guizhou. What we made, if we stir fry, there's always green onions. There's a kind of green onion in Guizhou. We call it shallot. Shallot is always in our dishes because I make vegetarian food. Vegetarians can eat with things with green onions and garlic, so I change those with Asian basil. In a result, the buns are matching with basil quite well.Making tofu buns, of course, the key part is tofu. The texture of tofu in Guizhou is different with the soft tofu in Taiwan. Lu tasted all kinds of products of beans in Taiwan. She found that the most similar texture with Guizhou tofu is Taiwanese dry tofu. In Guizhou, we use a kind of sour soup tofu. My hometown tofu is like dry tofu here. Taiwanese tofu is too soft, easily broken. Instead, I use dry tofu, which is like just like the tofu in my hometown, just like it. It's harder, could be sliced. However, the texture of the taste is still a little different because it's not pressed that hard. After I buy the dry tofu, I will blanch it with boiled water first. The tofu and dry tofu in Taiwan is bitter. Lu said that when she made tofu in Guizhou, she used soybeans into stone meal and added the soybean juice in the soup, spicing art to make it the solid tofu.When the tofu is cooked, the water cooked with tofu is just like the sourdough. It's the same property. There is a jar on each cooking stove. Every time you need to take the jar out, take 1 spoon of water from it. The water is for making for tofu. After finishing cooking tofu, while you're cooking tofu, you'll get the water out. And refill in the jar.Just repeat like this. Lu insists on making vegetarian without any meat. She also insists on not using additive products of vegetarian. All these products are handmade. She finds suitable vegetables to make hometown flavors. For ourselves, the process of making products are more important. Food, I always tell my customers said that I eat what I make too. You eat the food you made, so you need to eat at least.Lu also made the appetizer bok choy wire, which she learned from the ramen store she worked before, stir-frying with soy sauce wrapping in the buns. At first, we used shutters by our hands. Now we use machines. It takes at least 2 hours. Making the stuffing just like cooking, you have to like what you make first. When Lu found out that the buns and stuffed buns she made are not like the buns in her childhood, which is more chewy and solid,It's just like what I'm learning, I'm making it. In fact, in the beginning, every morning, I was here alone in early morning. I was every 5 a.m. Sometimes I got here around 4 in the morning. I was busy as beast because of my skills are not good enough. The steam buns, at first the steam buns were bulging, but gradually the buns cooled off. Most of the customers thought it was interesting. They'll still buy buns for me. They said my buns are very delicious and the dough smells good and tastes chewy. And the dough smells really good.The thing begun is half done. Although the experience with stuffed buns looks not so perfect in the beginning, but her customers, just like Lu Stiffing, every piece is sliced by her and stirred by herself. Let me tell you, it's free. You can come later because I just live next to you. You don't have to be busy running around.The neighbors nearby are regulars. They come to get buns and chat at the same time. Sometimes she will also help out. Some of them even come to the store at 8 a.m. every morning.Do we have back door today? I'm going to cook it later. It's not done yet. I'm cutting it now after I stir fry the fried tofu. I will cook burdock. More and more people become Lu's friends after they brought buns from her. Thinking of Lu, they will stop by to chat and show their care for her. Feel sorry for her. There is a serendipity between us, I think. You're a busybody. Don't forget to wrap the buns for me later. Okay.Someone will come and get that at 11 o'clock. Oh, Lu. Yesterday, Mr. Lin said don't forget his birthday peach buns to be tomorrow. Okay, I promised him I'd make big and fake fans for him. Thought, oh, don't forget, otherwise Mr. will be upset. There are Doba and Orba here. Oh, they're precious here. And Lu's old ones. I'm Dabo.
I'm Erbo.
Dabo and Erbo, they were neighbors who didn't know each other. Now they become regular customers also because their old mothers, they feel sorry for Lou that she had to raise her daughter all by herself. From this year, she was incumbent on selling buns for Lou. Sometimes we come here to buy buns. We know each other by buying the buns. How about Erbo?
I like her buns. I come to buy buns from her every often. I know she needs some help, so I will just to give her a hand.
How many years have you eaten the buns?
I have eaten her buns many years because I'm a vegetarian. I eat vegetarian because I like pure vegetarian. I don't like meat. Some stores sell meat and vegetarian buns. Although he sells vegetarian buns, but with the same steamer basket, although it's vegetarian buns, it will be mixed by the oil of the meat for sure. They are pure vegetarians. They will know what they eat.
Neighbors come here just like their own kitchen. Handmade vegetarian stuffed beans open Lou's new page of life. This price list in the store is made by her old co-workers. Lou said her buns are made by Tito's Taste. So towards her buns, she gives them the shiny name like Noble Bun.
Many of my customers keep telling me that you're really good doing all these by yourself. I tell him that, oh, I'm not alone. I got many favors from others. Because of their encouragement and assistance, Lou have a strong power to move forward. She said she used to live in a life without root on this land. Now she have many friends who are just like her sisters. She lives more happier, a vegetarian bun wrapped into heart and also to her vitality.
Do you remember that Taiwan had diplomatic relationship with a country in Europe called Macedonia? The diplomatic relationship only for 2 years, but it opened up a lot of windows of communication for these two countries, like spring painter Osuya. He came from Macedonia to study in Taiwan. She got married and have kids here. He was proudly say that even when he goes back to Macedonia, people there called him Taiwanese. Holding a paint spray can, using some shield, plus some newspaper thread, a unique painting, 3 to 10 minutes to finish. He is Osuya, a spring painter from Macedonia. 17 years ago, he came to Taiwan. In Taiwan, he fell in love with this beautiful land and the Taiwanese girl. 3 years ago, he self-learned spraying painting from internet, and he had his interest after he learned it. Last year, he started trying street performance. I saw on the internet there are many artists doing spraying painting, so I learned from them. Actually, I'm an artist. I paint because I want to purify my mind. When I paint, there are many ways to clean my mind. Although he had the foundation of painting, however, oil painting is different from other color paint. In addition to painting fast, how to avoid the paint drying up, there's also problems of bubbles while painting the paint. All these need to take some time to figure it out. When you mix the color, you have no idea how to mix it. Sometimes you don't know how to put it less or put it more. And sometimes when you add more, there are more bubbles coming out then. Bubbles are the first enemy for spraying painting. When bubbles come out, the more you make, the more you could experience. You will understand this. As a member of Slavic peoples, if O didn't speak, he looks serious. Especially when he is concentrating on painting, you will feel he is not easy to get along with. But O says that, in fact, he really likes to discuss painting with visitors and he likes to accept a challenge of customized work. In the beginning, in spraying painting, you need to know what to do because when you spraying painting, you have to follow the steps step by step. At first, you have to draw the planets and then the whole pictures. then the pillars and the mountains. You have to paint step by step. I like my customers discuss painting with me and tell me how does he like the sky, the moon, and other details. I really like this customer.He accepts customized orders. The contents are various. Even the place he paints on would not be limited on canvas. Many people will ask me to paint on their cars or their houses or their companies. I will go help them. He painted on houses and cars before. All said that painting on the hood of cars is the easiest. It's just like enlarged drawing paper, but the difficult part is on the drawl.It's vertical because it's very perpendicular. Working on the vertical materials is hard, uncomfortable pose. Parallel one is easier. Just like this is much more easier. Why? Because the pictures are underneath. The drawing on the wall, the point is not ergonomic. Moreover, while spray painting,It keeps going down, drawing while flowing down, so we shall use special paint. It will dry faster. So if you spray or draw on the wall, use this fast dry paint spray. 10-year-old son got talents from dad too, exposed to a very young age. On this holiday, he will go with O on the street to try painting.5. Right. Five planets. You're great. The close interactions between father and son tell us that Oh cares about family. Go, go!Go, go! I ran very fast! Come on! Oh still got three infant daughters. On the other low of low is Nanny. Daddy, I want to go higher! It's high enough. No, it's very hard. It's a sweet burden. Great. Seeing them being so happy. How do you feel with four children? Very good. The more the better. The more better?Will you plan to have other kids? Oh, now is enough. The four children are all O's masterpiece. However, they are still too young. The couple take care of them and staying around with them, which is tiring enough. Are you happy, honey? Are you happy? Are you happy? Okay, let's make pizzas. Come on. We're making pizza now. It's very hot. It's very hot. Let's have some water, shall we? Do you feel itchy on your back?He holds his twin daughter's hand on both sides. They're chatting on their way home. Just like noon sun on the fall is the happiness within warmth. Okay, let's... Oh, wait. Shall we wash our hands first? Here. Sit right here. Okay, good. You're the best. Just entering the door, always by in the kitchen.With making pizza with their lunch, putting pizzas in the oven, he helped his kids to take a shower. Seeing him do the housework quickly and agilely, compared to that year because of the politics, the big boy studying in Taiwan, everything is hard to imagine. The president, diplomatic relations, then we came. President Lee told us to come here. 100 students came. I came here to study in Minchi University.When I come to Taiwan, I thought Taiwan is great. At that time, Oh was just 22 years old. He could neither speak English nor Mandarin. He could only speak Macedonian language. After staying in Taiwan for 3 years, he was a customer for this place too. He could even speak fluent English with a Taiwanese girl at lunch room, and this girl now is Oh's wife. In addition to loving her at first sight, Oh also believes that it's God's will.I pray to the Lord that I want to have a wife. Yes, and God promised me. And then she showed up, and now she's my wife. Do you do that too? Did you pray too? Yes, I did. How did you pray? I prayed to meet my Mr. Right, just like this. Yes, so coincidentally, I met him. They fell in love with each other at first sight, and they got married because of the belief of Orthodox. All felt a strong responsibility to his family. Very strong, his ideas of family is very strong, and he would think family should be very close. And we can't. He thinks that he and I should be one. We are one body, not two people. He thinks he and I should not just be, should be one body, and we should not separate with each other. It's because he cares family a lot, so. This combination family with Taiwan and Macedonia, it is wife to ask her husband to go out and have fun, but husband would rather spend time with kids. Just like Macedonia family. My two hands should be out. Some of my husbands from the other countries, they would find their friends going out for drinking or doing something relaxing. But since we got married, he always got me out of it, but I said I don't want. He always thinks he should spend all his time with kids. I have some friends. When I miss them, I could take my family to visit them. You draw very well. You draw it very well. You are very good. Because he loves his children, always admiring everything about Taiwan. He only complained is the education for their kids. And this is the only diversity of this couple. Many kids are just sitting on the chairs learning from morning to evening. They learn a lot of things that they don't need. Sometimes all they do is just repeating, practicing, and they don't have time to play and have fun. From Monday to Friday, from every day, from morning to the evening, all they do is just studying and sitting at the desk. I don't think that's appropriate from some kids. All's education is to let children explore by themselves. So while he is making pizza, his children will play flower. If they want to paint, they could paint anywhere they want. Sometimes they will make a mess at home, and my husband will say, it's okay, we could clean it up later. And sometimes children will get some themselves colors and paintings and all their clothes. But my husband thinks this is how kids do. They grow up while they're exploring, and we get it used to it already. We feel like it's fine, we'll clean it later. After you play, I will clean it. Except for his appearance and his accent of Mandarin, Oh is really a Taiwanese. He likes to eat chicken soup and fly to night markets. When he is sick, he only took Chinese medicine. Not only taking Chinese medicine, he also takes Africure. It's in Macedonia. We also have Macedonia herb medicine. We also have that too. Those are good things. It's natural herbs. It's no harm for you. That's something will harm your body. He thinks Western medicine is chemistry. It's made of chemistry ingredients. He thinks Chinese herb medicine is more natural. When our kids get sick, he always take them to see Chinese medicine doctor. Integrating in this land deeply, Oh said proudly that he's already been a Taiwanese in others' eyes. When I go back to Macedonia, my friends call me Taiwanese, and they will say sometimes, here comes the Taiwanese. Taiwanese is back. What do you think yourself is? I think I am half Taiwanese. The good part of me is Taiwanese. Hold it, or else you will cut yourself. Yes, that's great. Who said that? A character of cartoon. Did Daddy say that? 70 years ago, he knows nothing about Taiwan, and he was here to study a foreign land. 17 years later, he had a family with 6 members. Asking, oh, does he have other dreams? He watches his family with satisfaction. This is everything. I'm living in my dream as an artist. I'm living in my dream. I could draw my own future with my dearest wife, with whole supports, my children. My dream is to watch my children growing up, watch them get married. This will be my future, and this is my dream.
In recent years, yoga has become an unmistakable trend, and in Taiwan, it has changed a lot of people's life. Like Cheng Qingzhao from Vietnam, after 10-year marriage in Taiwan, she was divorced with her husband, and every time she thinks about her children, she spends her days in tears, got in touch with Toka. Gradually, she found peace in her heart, even gave the classes help to help more people.Pull up. Good. Breathe and bend your body. Good. Breath and lift up. Step backward on your left foot, right foot move forward, backward, slide forward like a snake.I have been learning yoga, and this is my process of practice, and I think I get the health with just mental and physically, which is good to me. I want to share this present to my students to let more people know how great is yoga. In addition to good health, it could help us to manage our emotion to make it better. Bend your knees a little, pull up both hands. Okay, slowly.Yoga is originated from ancient India and has become an unmistakable trend. Yoga is a kind of exercise via the extension of body and muscle to let more people understand of themselves more. Your left hand, please, and you'll put your right hand here. The groin here. Open your feet and bend your whole body. This hard yoga pose is called the crow's feet and hand style. It's necessary to have strong muscles. Muscular endurance is a must. The calm, relaxed model is yoga coach Zhang Chao from Vietnam. In Taiwan for 20 years, in fact 10 years ago, she was a hairstylist working in a hair salon. Stepping in the world of yoga because there's a story about a tough woman.Hello, how are you? It's been a long time. It's been a long time. How have you been? Sit here. In 1995, Zhang got married in Taiwan. In order to support the family, also led her family in Vietnam to have a better life, Zhang attended many hairstyling programs actively.Become an hairstylist and increase more income as she wishes. However, the relationship between her and her husband were getting worse. In the end, this 10 years marriage ended unfortunately. I just about to go back to Vietnam, but for the sake of the two kids, so I just stay in Taiwan. After divorcing, my life were completely dark. I was not happy at all, but very unhappy.I even had a little depression. She thought she was strong enough, however, Zhang was unable to recover from the pain of divorcing, especially because of her two kids. She spent many days in tears. Every time my children came to my place, after one day I have to send them to my ex-husband's house, I would miss them very much. They imagine I miss my kids a lot, and that was really a sad thing for me.We cried together very often. She cried and I cried. And I think I am old enough to become her mother, so I encouraged her all the time. The close friend that she met in her hairstyling program always gave her warmth and cares. Even if it was hard for her, at least she had someone to depend on. It's a coincidence. Zhang exposed to yoga course. Unexpectedly through yoga, she found peace in her heart, which has disappeared for a while.When I practiced, I felt like my whole heart was placed on each movement of yoga, and I even tried to have tea myself. Therefore, every movement I made, I felt very pleasant. When she just started to learn yoga, Zhang asked herself to do every movement perfectly. Because of the over-practicing, there was one time that when she practiced with her classmates, she hurt her vertebra accidentally, and somehow she was unable to control her left leg. Your back is too far from the wall. After I got hurt, I think I was pretty depressed because my left leg was gradually shriveling.And doctor told me I must have a surgery. He told me if I choose not to have a surgery, my leg in the future might not be able to work. Whether she wants to have a surgery or not may drown into a dilemma after spine surgery is a big surgery. At the crosshairs, the only thing John concerned about is her children. Afterward, I made the plan for the worst result, and I decided to go to the surgery. However, I just took some issues. For example, if after the surgery I was unable to wake up in this way, I asked my friend to tell my children which items that I put those items at. Fortunately, the surgery was successful. Her body was recovered too, but however, this experience didn't kill Zhang's passion to yoga. Even though that her friend all don't support this idea at all, Zhang knows very clearly that the inner peace that yoga brings to her is priceless. When I was alone in Taiwan, somehow I was in a very bad mood, and whenever I heard some sad songs, I felt like to cry. But yoga really made me. For example, when I sit still, I could feel that I am spaced out. When I try to space out my whole body, and I think it's really helpful. Doing yoga is very helpful for me. That's why after I hurt myself, I still insist on doing yoga. I also encourage her that since you love yoga that much, would you like to try in this field to be a yoga teacher as your career? Starting over again after hurt, this time Zhang knows how to slow her pace. Before challenge her limit, she would protect herself first, and she keeps being progressing. Finally, in 2012, she got licensed for yoga coach. Since then, conduct courses. Her life changed ever since. When I try to get the certificate, it is because I want to make some progress. I give myself a very high standard. I'd like to upgrade myself. I'd also wish to more people would feel sure about me, not for myself, that assurance. Zhang takes every chance to advance herself, to evaluate herself. When she attended Yoga Masters, Corey Wu's advanced program, the master pointed out Zhang's real deed. Corey Wu looked at me and felt that I was a kind of a melancholy or something else or other meaning. He thought I was lack of the power. Therefore, I started to practice some movement like Yogic Yoga, and I think I found something I really like. Lift up your left leg. Practicing the movement of Yogic Yoga makes Zhang's softness to her body and reach a perfect balance of the strength of body, helps her to find her confidence. This turning point led her step up with fate to challenge something that is really popular in Taiwan recently, aerial yoga. I use this rope to adjust my body and to strengthen my muscle endurance and my kernel. Because aerial yoga could not only train our flexibility, but also the muscle endurance of our body to strengthen our energy. Aerial yoga is using a hanging cloth its flexibility and bouncing into a high level of movement of yoga expressed more easily. Hanging on the cloth, Zhang's expression is calm and relaxing, just like being in another world. When I was up there, hanging around, I really enjoyed the feeling. Just like in my childhood, there are many moments that bring me back to the time of my childhood and really makes me relaxed. It's just like felt like a swing. Hanging around without any worries, and I could be really relaxed. During their lessons, Zhang always have a heart to share to guide more students. Maybe because she got hurt before, she cares safety more than any others. I think normally when we go to A, in general the teacher will just teach A, but the teachers won't tell you B. But Zhang would teach me B and C or something more. And she's very positive and active because she got hurt before. I think she really cares about students' safety. Okay, breathe like a cat, bend your back, shrink the lower abdomen, hold on your chin good, hold up the rope tightly with both hands, then breathe. Stand on your tiptoe, move forward to let your body go. Very good. Watch your classmates next to you. Okay, go. She won't force you to make this movement and teach something too difficult for you. Basically, for example, with some high-level movement, she would teach us slowly. Bring up your right feet slowly and step on the floor firmly. Usually immersed in yoga classes, Zhang's main life besides yoga is a pair of her tutors. When she got divorced, her children were little. However, from each card that is made by her children, she can feel their love to their mom. I think my mom is very pretty and very confident and very strong-willed to learn everything.She's a wonderful mother. She could go back to Vietnam, but she doesn't. All she does is for us and let us to grow up in Taiwan. And sometimes there are some activities at school, and she would be like to attend those activities. And I feel proud to have her because she's beautiful. Sweetie, Mom know you like to lead this.I cherish this moment very much because only one day, just one day a week, if there's any chance I would want to stay with my mom, I cherish the time very much. For the sake of two kids, Zhang's never bothered of her divorce or sport injuries. She starts all over again. She hopes in the future, year after year, she could always protect her children. To Zhang, it's her original and final wish. It's her greatest happiness without any regrets. Speaking of Tibet, what comes to your mind at first timing? In fact, in Taiwan, there's a good place that you would go the culture of Tibet that you not only try on Tibetan clothes, but also make the food staple of Tibetan sampa. How to make it? Let us take you to experience.I always wish when I joined this family as I was into another time and space, like returning into the home in Tibet. To Chai Wong himself, Taiwan, a foreign country, because of this home, let him feel familiar, let him find a stable home. Chai Wong's and Lei's house is located in a very small valley in Taichung City.In this quiet and the crowded city, it seems to be a different world. Here it is. Yes, this is our home. Hello, hello. Arranging their house as a Tibetan residence, first only work on friends or visiting guests, but many backpackers visit. The couple just simply let their home open for Tibetan cultural experience, such as experiencing space actually to us. We're still unable to cover it. And I think Tibetan is a kind of nation that which is beautiful and mysterious. And I think through this space, we could make many kinds of different friends and those who like Tibetan culture. Well, I want to know more about Tibet culture for us. I think so here is a very wonderful place. This cultural experience trip starts from Tibetan clothes, and Tibetan dressing is a branch of knowledge too. In the winter, during the Grand Festival, you could wear like this. And when you are, if you are going to the temple, you have to take careof this piece, and someone would hide this piece inside here. Yes, just like this. This is to show your respect. Wearing traditional Tibetan clothes, it feels like you become a strong man in the Tibetan plateau. And the dressing of female here is quite particular too. In addition to the local clothes, they also put on the head ornaments with folk style and to be an authentic traditional Tibetan girl for once.After dressing up, everyone takes their camera and taking picture happily. However, this is just the first stop of experiencing. Next, Chai Hong was going to teach everyone to make good staples of Tibet Sampa.
puts guac into the world first. It is a unique dairy product of Tibet, heated up with milk, boiling till it becomes solid. After exposure in the sunlight and hair drying, it tastes more like dry cheese. Then pouring the milk tea and the yellow ghee and last adding some sambal powder, adding all the ingredients. How does it taste? Is it chowdy? It depends on the skill. Middle skill. Yes, and poke. Your palm can't leave the bowl. Yes.Turn it and hold it. Turn it and hold it. Seeing the zamba in their hand forming, everyone can't wait to taste it. When you're chewing it, you will feel the aroma of cereal, which is different from the rice. The taste is not common to taste in Taiwan. It's very special. In fact, it is rare in Taiwan to have the whole package of Tibetan spirits. Yes, I think it's really special.During the experience, Chai Hoang introduced the culture of Tibetan in detail and answers to each question seriously. It's not hard to see that Chai Hoang's care and insist about his hometown called the traditional culture. However, the two promotes the culture he used to feel frustrated with the cultural difference of Taiwan and Tibet and feels very often that when guests left here, there's a lot of sambal on the tables not eaten it, they will feelmake us feel shocked because basically it's not easy to get the ingredients of zampa. It's just like the rice to us. It's very precious. And there was used to be a period of time if we feel very frustrated. Coming from the Tibet, which is lack of supply, since Taiwan was young, he had no idea that to not cherish the food. His wife Lei noticed his frustration and in addition to the encouragement, she thinks, why don't we give the guests an opportunity to learn?They will remind the guests particularly to come to experience during the mealtime, to try to eat less before the experience. We also provide plastic bags to let customers take out the zampa. When they are served as customer and not zampa, they also make traditional Tibetan dessert kopsi. Kopsi, generally in Tibet, is a food that you could only eat during the New Year's.Or some other big festivals. Usually after we make the kopsi, we will serve to the Buddha first, then the whole family would enjoy together. Even not a normal couple, sometimes they will be bicker with each other and quarrel with each other, not mentioning these two people are from different backgrounds of children, but we believe that as long as we have the same heart, we could get through all the tests and difficulties, and many problems would just be solved. They insist they are not in the fight when they won't make kopsi, even if there's one peopleMaking it, they won't do it. In other words, the principle of this couple that will not make kopsi if one is absent. And Tibet, it looks like a lotus, means cleanliness. And Taiwan, we also give it to another term, it's called A. It's because its shape is like a heart connects each other by one. Yes, therefore, we call it husband and wife cake. Admit some people used to suggest us, for example, adding some green tea or sesame. They will think this way this will make taste more various.But to us, it's a traditional food. It's a cultural inheritance. So to us, it's very important to keep this traditional, insisting the tradition. Instead of catering the taste of majority, this is Taiwan's insist, and they take kopsi as a signature product in the store, because when they got married, they took kopsi to replace the wedding cookies to share the joys in their marriage.This wedding is quite special, not only kept by the traditional customs of Tibetan, as believed as Catholic lay, also invited godfather to conduct their marriage. Thank you, Lord. The two people with different cultures and religions come from two countries with 100 miles of distance. Their love story started from the year when Chai Hong was 19 years old.At that time, he left Tibet to study in India. They met Lei from Taiwan to India, who taught Mandarin there. They met each other and decided to marry 3 years ago. But after marriage, their first trial was turned out to be life and death. When we got married, we were in India. Maybe because she was unable to adapt there, the medical checkup result was hepatitis A, yes.Doctor did told her maybe she ate some contaminated food or food poisoning. When she was hospitalized because of intubation,
to see the picture, to see her that way, I felt very sad. When I see her being like that, I thought, okay, it's fine. Since we got married with each other, this is our fate. No matter what situation you are in, I will always accompany you with you. Staying in the hospital for 12 days, Lei finally recovered. Originally, they thought after the test, her life would be smooth ever since, but Cai Huang settled down in Taiwan with his wife and he just found the pressure of life coming around. Sometimes I really felt that. There seems to be a very thick head on my head, and the head covers all my head. As a new inhabitant, every half year I have to depart Taiwan, and the fee for departure is a big amount of money. Every time I depart from Taiwan, I have to spend $60 to $70,000. I have to prepare every will every day after year. At that time, my pressure was quite huge. Facing the pressure of economy, Cai Huang held it all himself. Lei staying with him felt sorry for him too. However, at this moment, they came out of the idea of Tibetan experience spaces, and they hoped the space could be a good start for them in Taiwan. However, Cai Huang just came here in Taiwan. He not only had to deal with money, as a new married man, he also had to integrate with his wife, family, is under test too. Is Cai Huang accustomed to fish now? Now it's okay. It's okay for me. I won't reject and scared, as I used to be. This egg, Lei cooked it very well. Good. I dare to eat egg. When we specially prepare some seafood, such as shrimps or fish, out of our expectation, he didn't eat it. I don't know why either, but it's impossible to force him to eat. Afterward, we realize that he doesn't eat fish. Yes, in the end, we just know Tibetan people don't eat seafood. Getting alone every day, they just found that the living habits are totally different. Lei's parents are from Minna and Hakka. With this Tibetan son-in-law, a period of adjustment was inevitable at first. Fortunately, Tibetan people had strong values about their family. Cai Huang's filthy and his attitude to disrespectful let him take his parents-in-law's approval very soon. They even love him as their own son. There are some heavier things my father was not able to move by himself, so he is very nice and thoughtful. In other words, whatever you ask him to do, he will do it, and you really have nothing to complain about the son-in-law. From being accustomed, not to now Cai Huang's accustomed with everything here. Lei is saying with a smile that Cai Huang is very similar to the old ladies in Taiwan. Every day after work, you could see him chatting around with neighbors. Do you know what is this? This is sausage. Sausage, sausage, yes. Sausage, do you know what's this? This is fish is sorry. Many people barbecue this on Moon Festival. Sorry, yes. This is corn. This is ornat corn. Water bamboo. Oh, water bamboo. Cai Huang made a lot of Taiwanese friends. The happiest thing is to share Tibetan culture to more people. He says, wherever a person is, the most important thing is not to forget your origin. Long from freedom make him love Taiwan. He not only takes Mandarin and Tibetan rough translation, he also published Tibetan picture books and plans to take Tibetan people back to their hometown, and he hopes to continue the feelings for Tibet in Taiwan to make this couple's dream fulfill in Taiwan. After watching Taiwan is My Home today, we hope it brings you more positive energy. Thank you for joining us. See you next week. Bye.